Hallo zusammen! Many of you will know or have even found out about my channel because of Rammstein and that I make Rammstein-related videos every now and then. Whether it's lyrics-related most of the time or like rankings, my favorite Rammstein songs, my favorite Rammstein albums. But having said that, however, well, there is much more to the German music scene and learning German with music than just Rammstein. And because that is, well, I wanted to start this new little video series that I'm gonna do every now and then, I guess. In this series, I'm focusing on single lines in German songs that are really, really cool, and I'm gonna explain them linguistically. I'm gonna mention what makes them great and what makes them really special in a way. This one is about one of those songs, two lines in this case, and it's a song by the German rock band Die Ärzte. I've made a video about them just recently, why they are one of Germany's most popular and biggest, most important bands to date. And I want to talk about two lines in their song Rebell. The song Rebell was released as a single off of Die Ärzte's highly successful album 13 in 1998. Even though the German punk rock legends are known for many humorous, sarcastic and funny tunes, they also have quite a few more serious songs in their discography, and this is one of them. By the way, the English Rebel is pronounced and stressed slightly differently to the German noun der Rebell, singular, die Rebellen, plural. To me, it's a great, great song about, you know, typical thoughts you might have when you are a teenager, a rebel against the system, your parents, morals, and, you know, wanting to live according to your own interests, beliefs, and experiences. It's even written from a teen's perspective, expressing their thoughts about their parents, how they relate to them, and typical examples of a discussion or arguments, which leads us to the lines in this video that I want to talk about. They are part of the second verse, which comes in right after the first chorus. Ich bin nicht taub, du brauchst nicht so zu schreien. Ich bin nicht blind, ich sehe es nur nicht ein. I'm not deaf, you don't need to scream like that. I'm not blind, I just don't see why. So I hope that even though you might not have the whole context of the song, you might still get what this is about. So let's begin with the first line. The first part is the lyrical I expressing what they are not. They are neither deaf nor blind, even though their parents somehow might begin to think that because, you know, the lyrical I, and a rebellious teen in this case, I'd say, doesn't follow their rules the way they did when they were still a child anymore. So, yeah. The parents can't really cope with the situation, they might be hilflos, helpless, and especially ratlos, at a loss or clueless, as to what they might have done wrong and what they could do to change that. The second part of the first line is something the lyrical I makes clear in a direct correspondence with their parents. You don't need to scream or shout at me, I am not deaf. I just don't want to hear your Beschwerden, complaints, again and again. If you have a problem, well, that's your problem, not mine. This could be a direct reply to the parents after they might have said something along the lines of, are you blind? How could you wear that for school today? Are you deaf? Turn down the volume! Both parties, the teen and the parents, are arguing about things, yet in a really emotional instead of a rational way. And it's especially the second line I want to highlight in this video. You might have noticed a recurring structure at the beginning of both lines. Ich bin nicht, I am not, In that sense, and in direct relation to the other lines in this verse, these are part of die Aufzählung, the list or enumeration. What I really like, not only about these two lines that I'm talking about here in this video, but about the song in general, is that it really, really showcases, it really highlights, well, the different types of conversations parents might have with teens and their kids, and the different, well, opinions, and even something like a Vorstellung, an imagination, or an idea about how life should be. This song really captures and captivates that feeling, those emotions, those different morals so well. It's such a great song, honestly. Ich bin nicht blind, ich sehe es nur nicht ein. Literally means, I am not blind, I see it just not on. Doesn't make too much sense like this, I know, but it's important to understand why this whole line is a clever German lyric. It also goes to show that the second half contains a separated German verb, which is typical for many conjugated German verbs in specific syntactical contexts. In this case, it's a conjugated form of the verb etwas einsehen, to realize, to understand, to accept something. Ich sehe ein. I realize, accept. In this case, however, it's negated. The teen doesn't see any reasonable sense in accepting certain rules, wishes or morals lived by the parents or other Erwachsene, adults in general. Ich sehe nicht ein. I don't accept that. Combining this with the introducing part, the separated and negated conjugated verb sehe nicht ein forms a cool linguistic play with the meaning of the adjective blind, blind. Ich bin nicht blind, ich sehe es nur nicht ein. And, as I've mentioned before, translated rather loosely, you could also say I'm not blind, I just don't see. Why? I should accept that, you know. Cool little puns like this one really lift a song on the lyrical side of things, I think. And they are pretty special to many Ärzte songs as well, and especially to those that are written by Farin Urlaub, the singer and guitarist, or one of the singers, because actually all three band members sing every now and then. And he is such a great German songwriter, and in my opinion one of the best, like, in the last 40 years. It's especially his songs in Die Ärzte and his other band, the Farin Urlaub Racing Team, that can range from really, well, serious and philosophical topics even, to something that is really humorous and really hilarious as well. Something almost stupid, but it's so funnily and, you know, interestingly delivered that it's just cool. It's just creative and awesome. This song is no exception, although this one is one on the more like serious side of things. So I highly suggest checking out Die Ärzte and the Farin Urlaub Racing Team. The Farin Urlaub Racing Team is, well, more similar to, let's say, heavy rock and even metal at times, with also like trumpets and women's choir and stuff. Really, really epic, really unique in a way as well. If you want to learn more about Die Ärzte in specific, check out my video about them that I just did recently. Really, really cool band, one of my favorite German rock bands of all time. And, well, yeah, feel free to recommend this video to other people that are interested in German music and learning German with German music. So thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed this one, I certainly enjoyed making it. See you next time, I'm your Vlog Dave, tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.